on Friday the 2nd of December, and everyone in the United Benefice sends their best wishes to you all. Our opening prayer. We pray that God's faithfulness is known in a world which is full of change and hope, fear and adventure, and among our family, friends, and in our homes. Amen. Today's readings are Psalm 25 and Isaiah 44, verses 9 to 23. Political election campaigns often centre around the issue, who do you trust? This can be in general, or it can be narrowed down to specific areas, such as the health service, education, defence, or the economy. Who do you trust to satisfactorily handle each of these areas? It's actually quite probable that there isn't anyone who is able to handle those areas in the way that people are hoping for. That's why in a democracy, the political party in power fluctuates quite regularly. It's a case of, let's see what the other ones can do. At the very least, it's worth a try. And this is a behaviour pattern which God's people have followed, not relating to politics, but to God himself. They tried whatever options were around to see which one they thought gave them the best deal. This includes idols which have been made by human hands. Now, idols are inanimate objects and can't do anything except be there for people to look at and possibly admire the craftsmanship. But compare this with God, who has redeemed his people. As part of this, he has swept away and pardoned all their sins and offences. This is what the Lord has done and what he is capable of continuing to do. I don't think that there can possibly be any comparison between that and an inanimate object. Why look around for something else when God is indeed so mighty? As it says in Psalm 25, in you, Lord my God, do I put my trust. These are words familiar to us as we echo them every time we sing the much-loved hymn, Be Still and Know That I Am God. I touched on some of the major issues which are of concern at present, and my next prayer is relating to a global issue, that of climate change. Majestic Lord, we thank you for your marvellous creation. You made everything in perfect balance and harmony for the benefit of all. We are sorry that human greed and self-interest has disrupted the balance of creation. As we continue to experience more regular extremes of weather, we can't ignore the role that humans have played in global warming. We pray that we all seek your godly wisdom as to how this global warming can be reversed, and may we have the courage and resolve to take the necessary action. Amen. And then for the prayer points, I'm picking up on some of the areas of concern I touched on in my earlier reflection. Let's continue to pray about the economy. Pray about the pressures on the NHS and the wider care sector, and pray for everyone who is involved in education. The Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. I hope that everyone has a good weekend and our blessing. To Jesus the King, eternal, immortal, invisible, the only God, be honour, glory and power forever and ever. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son and Holy Spirit, be with you and with you.